Good morning, students. Welcome to the online classes of Ready Memorial Senior Secondary School. Today, we are going to start our another chapter in English Grammar Book. The name of the chapter is Active and Passive Voice. Okay. Now, first of all, we'll start with what is a voice. A voice is the form of verb which expresses its connection with the doer. It expresses the connection with the doer, the subject. It makes clear whether the subject is doing something or something is being done by it. Okay. Kinds of voices. There are two voices, active and passive voice. We have read about it a lot. Now let's move on to what is an active voice. In active voice, the verb shows that the subject is doing something. Subject does something. Whatever is done, it is done by the subject. Okay, subject is doing something. Like the farmer grows fruits and vegetables. Okay, the passive voice shows something is done by the subject. Active says subject does something, passive says something is done by the subject. The farmer grows fruits and vegetables is active, and fruits and vegetables are grown by the farmer. This is your passive voice. Okay. There are general rules in active and passive voice. Replace the subject by the object that you need to do in each and every part using relevant helping verb. Okay, you need to see what helping verbs are being used there. Okay, you need to see that. Okay, plus you need to use the third form of verb after the object. Okay, every time third form of verb, put by after the third form of verb, that is helping verb. You need to see which tense it is. Helping verb plus verb third form plus by plus object. Okay, now put the subject of the active voice after by. When it was in the active, it was subject plus helping verb and anything else. When you are writing the passive voice, the subject will go to the end of the sentence and the object comes in the initial stage, in the first stage, at the first point. Okay. See here. The postman delivers letters. Letters are delivered by the postman. Okay, you will see how, I'll tell you why this R is used. Okay, and we'll see why. And now, if the subject is a pronoun, we need to change it as follows: I into me, we into us, you into you, whom by whom, he, him, she, her, it, they, them. Okay, now we need to study carefully these sentences and we'll understand the formulas, the rules later on. We play hockey, hockey is played by us. I'm writing a story is being written by me. We have solved the sum has been solved by us. He killed a snake was killed by him. I was washing clothes, clothes were being washed by me. She had painted the wall had been painted by me. I shall score good marks, the good marks will be scored by me. He will have deposited the fee will have been deposited by him. Okay? Now, the sentences in the following tense can't be changed into passive. Remember, future continuous, present perfect continuous, past perfect continuous and future perfect continuous. So, these tenses do not change themselves into passive one. Okay? They remain active. Now, let's study them one by one. Moving on to present continuous tense. What is there? Assertive. Assertive is the simpler one. Okay. Subject plus is MR plus verb first form plus ing plus object. Okay. Here, simple sentence used in present continuous is she is plucking flowers. And the change will be is object comes here. Object and subject are replaced. Object comes here, subject here. Now is MR is same. And I told you in the general rules, being plus verb third form, because it is continuous here, I need to add being here. Okay, being plus change the first word into first verb into third verb. Okay, plus by plus subject. She is plucking flowers. Flowers are being plucked by her. Okay, if it is a negative one in continuous. Subject plus is MR plus not plus verb first form plus ing plus object. She is not plucking flowers. Now again object comes here, subject here. Everything remains same, just need to add a not. Object plus is MR plus not plus B plus verb third form plus by plus subject. She is not plugging flowers, flowers are not being plugged by her. Interrogative is MR plus subject plus verb first form plus ing plus object. Is she plucking flowers? Is MR plus object plus B plus verb third form plus by plus subject. Is she plucking flowers? Are the flowers being plucked by her? Okay, so this one is your present continuous, which is active into passive along with the rules. Moving on to perfect one. Subject plus has a plus verb third form plus object. He has paid his dues. Now, subject and object interchange. Object plus has a plus been, because it is perfect, so we'll add been here. Been plus verb third form, that is compulsory. Verb third form plus by plus subject. He has paid his dues. His dues have been paid by him. Now, see students, because dues is a plural thing, okay, it's a plural, so we have used have here. Don't get confused. He is a singular person. He has paid his dues. His dues have been paid by him. Okay. In negative, subject plus has have plus not plus verb third form plus object. He has not paid his dues. His dues have not been paid by him. Just added not here. Okay. Everything is same in this. Now, helping verb comes first because it is interrogative, asking questions. Has have plus subject plus verb third form plus object. Has he paid his dues? Has or have plus object plus been plus verb third form plus by plus subject. Have his dues been paid by him? Okay, students. Next one, simple past tense. What is there? In the simple past tense, assertive one, active is subject plus verb second form plus object. He brought the slate. And here it is object plus was verb because it is past tense. So it is was verb plus third form plus by plus subject. He brought the slate. The slate was broken by him. Okay. Subject and object are interchanged. Because it is past, we are using was verb plus, that's obvious, we need to use the third form and by. Okay. So he broke the slate was broken by him. Subject plus did not plus verb first form plus object. He did not break the slate. Object plus was verb plus not plus verb third form plus by plus subject. The slate was not broken by him. Okay. The slate was not broken by him. Interrogative. Did subject verb first form plus object. Remember students, whenever you use did in any sentence, use first form of verb. I have seen a lot of students committing the same mistakes, that they use did with any other form of verb, that is second form or third form. Please don't use that. Don't do that. Okay. If you are using did, just use the first form of verb with it. Okay. Now, did plus subject plus verb first form plus object. You must have seen here also it was did and first form. Here also it's did and first form. Okay. Did he break the slate? Was verb plus object plus third form plus by plus subject. Was the slate broken by him? Okay. I think you understood it in a better manner now. Moving ahead to past continuous. Assertive for past continuous is subject plus was verb plus first form of verb plus ing plus object. He was solving an exercise. Here what it is written? Object plus was verb plus being. Because it is continuous, as we read in the present continuous tense, if it is continuous, use being. If it is perfect, use being, B-E-E-N, being. Here it is continuous, so I am using B-I-N-G, being. B-E-I-N-G, being. Now there was interchange, object plus was verb plus being plus third form plus by plus object. He was solving an exercise was being solved by him. Okay. Now negative, subject plus was verb plus not plus verb first form plus ing plus object. Again helping verb and then not. Same here, object and subject interchange, helping verb plus not plus being plus verb third form plus by plus subject. And he was not solving an exercise was not being solved by him. Okay. Now the interrogative one, was verb plus subject plus verb first form plus ing. Here, because it is question asking, so helping verb is starting the sentence. Was he solving an exercise? Then, was an exercise being solved by him? Everything is same in past and present continuous. Only difference is for the helping verb. Okay. I'm telling you, when you change it into passive, only difference is about the helping verb in past continuous and present continuous. As if you talk about the tense, the active voice, they are different. Okay. Now moving on to past perfect. Now see, subject plus had plus verb third form plus object, they had already solved the exercise. Now in perfect tense, we need to add had plus been. Okay, and it is compulsory to use third form and why in every passive. So subject plus had, subject changes with object. Okay, see, okay, object plus had been plus verb third form plus by plus subject. They had already solved the exercise had already been solved by them. Okay, negative subject plus had plus not plus verb third form plus object. They had not solved the exercise. Object plus had plus not plus been plus verb third form plus by plus subject. The exercise had not been solved by them. Interrogative had plus subject plus third form plus object. Had they solved the exercise? Had they solved the exercise? Now this one had helping verb coming here because it is an interrogative sentence. Had they solved the exercise? Had the exercise been solved by them? Again the same thing. Okay, because it is perfect, we are using been in every passive voice. Okay, and third form because it is perfect, and had because it is past perfect. Okay, if it was present perfect, then we would have used has or have. Okay, now moving on to simple future tense. Now what is simple future tense? Simple future tense, she will perform a folk dance. Subject plus shall, will shall plus verb first form plus object. Okay, subject plus will shall plus first form of verb plus object. She'll perform a folk dance. Changing into object plus will shall plus be plus third form plus by plus object plus subject. Okay, in future we'll add be. Okay, be plus third form plus by plus subject. She'll perform a folk dance. A folk dance will be performed by her. Okay. Negative subject plus shall will plus not plus verb first form plus object. I shall not tell a lie. Now object interchanges with subject again. Object plus will shall plus not plus be plus third form plus by plus subject. I shall not tell a lie. A lie will not be told by me. Okay. Now don't get confused. Here it is written I shall and here a lie will. Because I is with I every time shall is used. Okay. Interrogative shall or will plus subject plus verb first form plus object. Shall will because it is interrogative, so helping verb is starting the question, the interrogative sentence. Shall or will plus subject plus first form of verb plus object. Now will shall plus they are interchanging object plus be plus verb third form plus by subject. Will she perform a folk dance? Will a folk dance be performed by her? Okay. Moving on for the future perfect tense. So moving on to future perfect tense, what is assertive? Subject plus will shall plus have plus verb third form plus object. He will have posted the letter. Now interchange subject with object. Will shall plus have plus been. Here because it is perfect, we'll be using been plus verb third form plus by plus subject. The latter will have been posted by him. Negative subject plus shall will plus not plus have plus third form plus object. Object plus shall will plus not plus have been plus or third form plus by plus object. Interchanging the object and subject, shall will remain same, not will add be here because it is perfect tense. Will not have posted the letter. The letter will not have been posted by him. Okay. In now interrogative, helping verb starts the sentence. Shall will plus subject plus have plus third form plus object. Okay. Will he have posted the letter? Shall will plus object plus have been plus third form plus by plus subject. Will he have posted the letter? Will the letter have been posted by him? Okay. Will the letter have been posted by him? So this one is your future perfect tense. Now there are some sentences that may confuse you all. Okay, there are a lot of sentences. Like there are imperative sentences. Let's check out what is there. Formation of passive voice for imperative sentences. What are imperative sentences? They ask, they order, or they appeal. Okay. Moving on to this one. What is the formation? Let plus object, to be plus third form of verb, or you are requested, ordered or advised plus to plus first form plus object. You will understand this one with the help of example. Okay. Leave your phone outside this room. Leave your phone outside this room. Let your phone be left outside this room. Okay. Let your phone be outside this room. Or you are advised to leave first form your phone. Okay, now your is your subject. Okay, and so your phone is the object. Okay, now you are advised to leave your phone outside this room. Shut the window. Let the window be shut. Give me your book, please. You are requested to give me your book. Do not tease the dog. Let the dog not be teased. You are advised not to tease the dog. Okay. Now, what if this interrogative sentence? Do you like milk? Is milk liked by you? Who killed the snake? By whom the snake was killed? I told you to change who with by whom. Will you post this letter? Will this letter be posted by you? Did you find the solution? Was the solution found by you? Is she teaching the students? Are the students being taught by her? Where were you playing football? Where was football being played by you? Has he bought a new house? Has a new house been bought by him? Had you finished your work? Had your work been finished by you? How do you do this? How is this done by you? Can you solve this sum? Can this sum be solved by? Now, what if a model is used? Okay, we can win the game. The game can be won by us. I should forgive him. He should be forgiven by me. We must respect our elders. Our elders must be respected by us. Basically, these models are used here in active and passive voice. Okay, he may win the first position. The first position may be won by them. Now, what if the sentence is having two objects? She gave me an advice. Okay. And an advice was given to me by her. You can write, I was given an advice by her. Advice by her. I gave my brother a new shirt. A new shirt was given to my brother by me. Or my brother was given a new shirt by me. Let's find out in the exercise. The officer issued him a warning letter. A warning letter was issued to him by the officer. My mother gave me a book on aliens. I was given a book on aliens by my mother. Okay. The scientists have gifted us several wonderful gadgets. We were gifted several wonderful gadgets by the scientist. Will you give me your phone number? Will the phone number be given to me by you? Okay. Or So these are the examples, and we have taken some exercise questions also. And this was your active and passive students. I hope you understood the chapter very well, because we had done a lot of examples in the chapter itself. So I think you understood it in a better manner. If you like the video, please press the like button, subscribe to our channel, share the video. We'll meet you in the next video for sure. Till then, take care. Have a nice day. Thank you.